going to discuss about electrostatics. It is one of the branch of physics that deals with stationary electric charge. Come, let's watch.
Hi students, this is Durga Kumaresh. Today we are going to discuss about electrostatics. In this lecture, we are going to see some of the basic facts related to this topic. I don't want to go directly into the topic. Now, one second. This is the topic, electrostatics. Electrostatic is the branch of electricity that deals with the effects of stationary charges and their related phenomena. Stationary charges means charges which are at rest. In this, we are going to see different types of forces that are available in nature and the charges and its nature. First, we will see the different types of forces. You might have learned about all kinds of forces in your lower classes. Now we will see the different types. Basically, it is divided into two types. One is contact forces, another one is non-contact forces. Under contact forces, we have different types, that is applied force, air resistance force, frictional force, tension in a string, spring force, etc. Here, if you look at all the forces are basically arises only because of contact. These forces arises due to electromagnetic interaction. Then when we here look at the second one, non-contact forces. Under non-contact forces, we have gravitational force, magnetic force, electrostatic force, and nuclear force. In your 11th standard, you have learnt about gravitational force in detail. These are all non-contact forces. In our topic, we mainly focus our attention on electrostatic force, that is force between two static electric charges. Next one is electric charge. Here we will see what is charge and where do charges come from and properties of charges. First, what is charge? Charge of a material body or particle is the property due to which it produces and experiences electrical and magnetic effects. So here, look at this. It is the property of a body. So when you have an object, it has mass. Mass is one of the property of the object. Likewise, charge is one of the property of the object. Next one is, where do charges come from? So in order to understand this, we have to look into the microscopic view of an atom. Atom is the fundamental particle, that is the smallest particle of any matter. It is made up of proton, neutron, and electron. If you see the atomic structure, it has a nucleus at the center and electrons are revolving around different orbits. Nucleus has proton and neutron. Proton is positively charged and neutron has no charge. Electrons are which are revolving around the nucleus has negative charge. Next one is frictional electricity. What is frictional electricity? How can you charge an object? So this is the method to charge an object. There are different methods available to charge an object. This is one of the method, that is frictional electricity. It is otherwise called triboelectric effect. Here we have taken two examples. What is frictional electricity? It is the electricity produced by rubbing two suitable bodies and transfer of electrons from one body to other. Here we need two objects. The two objects are neutral initially. When the two objects are rubbed with each other, electrons are transferred from one object to another object. Due to this transfer of electrons, one object becomes positively charged and another object become negatively charged. Likewise, we can explain this one. Here ebonite and flannel are taken. Ebonite becomes negatively charged after rubbing and flannel become positively charged. Next one is properties of charges. Charges have different properties the two types of charges are positive and negative. We have already discussed positive charge and negative charge. The fundamental positive charges proton and fundamental negative charges electron. Unlike charges, attract with each other, and like charges repel with each other. See, here you can see plus charge and minus charge. They are unlike charges. They attract with each other, and like charges repel with each other. Here you can see the example. Two charged plastic rulers repel with each other. Two charged glass rods repel with each other. Charged glass rod attracts charged plastic ruler. Next property is conservation of charge. In an isolated system, sum of total charge remains constant. Whatever change takes place in that system. Here, when an object is charged, electron transfer takes place. One object becomes positively charged and another object becomes negatively charged. If you see the total number of charges in the system as a whole, that is constant. So, charge is conserved, constant. Next one is quantization of charge. Charge of a particle or a body is always an integral multiple of fundamental unit of electric charge. Fundamental unit of electric charge is charge of an electron, that is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb, where coulomb is the unit of charge. Here, charge of any object is represented by the letter capital Q, that is equal to N into E, where N is the integral number. It can take values from plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, etc. Next one is, charge is always associated with mass. Charge cannot exist without mass, though mass can exist without charge. And next one is, charge is relativistically invariant. Charge is a scalar quantity. Its SI unit is coulomb. A charge at rest produces only electric field around itself. Charge moving with uniform velocity produces electric and magnetic field both. An accelerated charge emits electromagnetic radiations. All the properties, remaining these three properties, you will see in your next chapters. Next one is the basic thing. You might have learnt about this one, grounding. An object is grounded when it is connected to the earth through a connecting wire. If a charged conductor is grounded, it will become neutral. The symbol to represent grounding, this is the symbol. How does grounding occur? When we touch metal ball of positive charge, what will happen? Electrons flow from the earth to the metal ball to neutralize the metal ball. Metal ball becomes neutral. Next one is, how does grounding occur? Similarly, if the metal ball is of negative charge, extra electrons flow from metal ball to the earth and the ball becomes neutral. Now we will see simple recap of what we have learnt so far. First one is, net charge of an atom is neutral. Objects becomes charged by gaining of or losing electrons. A positively charged object has fewer electrons than protons. A negatively charged object has more electrons than protons. A neutral object has equal number of electrons and protons. Charging can be done by triboelectric charging and then conduction and induction. Here we only discussed this one, that is triboelectric charging. And then electroscope is a device to detect the nature of charge. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, share, subscribe, and post your comments in the comment box. Thank you, one and all.